Available as of January 16th is the Switch Flex 2.5G PoE, which comes in at $199 MSRP. Looking at the specs, this appears to be an absolute powerhouse of a compact network switch. But is it right for you? Let's dig in and find out. All right, no fluff in this video. We are going to get this thing straight out of the box here. Oh, there we go. All right, we got some wall mount screws. We have the switch itself. Well, it's a little bit bigger than I thought it would be. We have a mounting bracket, and then we have a template for leveling this on the wall. So what we have here is 8 2.5 gigabit ports across the front. Each one of these is capable of PoE++ output for powering up devices such as access points, surveillance cameras, or similar PoE-powered equipment. It also has a pair of 10 gig uplink ports, and you can choose whether you want to use the 10 gig RJ45 or the 10 gig SFP Plus for that uplink. When you're using the 10 gig RJ45, you can power the switch with PoE in, and the power availability for your devices depends on the type of PoE that you're using to power up the switch. If you use PoE Plus, you get 12 watts of PoE for your devices. It's plenty of power for like a couple of devices, an access point and a surveillance camera, something like that. If you're using PoE Plus, you get 37 watts of PoE to share across the 8 2.5 gig ports. And if you use PoE++++, you get 57 watts of PoE across these ports. And I know what some of you may be thinking. Okay, I know about PoE, or 802.11at. I know about PoE++, also known as 802.11bt. But what the heck is PoE++++? All right, so let's sidetrack for a moment and let's talk about these various PoE standards. Standard PoE, also known as 802.3AF, uses two pairs of wires within the Ethernet cable, and it can provide a maximum of 12.5 watts of power to your devices. Within an Ethernet cable, there are 8 total wires, or 4 pairs. Being that 802.11AF uses 2 of those pairs, that means that it's using 4 of the wires within the Ethernet cable for power. The next step up is PoE Plus, or 802.3AT, which also uses 2 pairs of wires, but it's able to deliver up to 25.5 watts of power to your devices. Then we have PoE++, also known as 802.3bt. Now, PoE++ covers 2 different categories. You got 802.3bt type 3, which can deliver up to 51 watts to your end devices, as well as 802.3bt type 4, which can deliver up to 90 watts for your end devices. I know this is all clear as mud, right? So what then is PoE++++? Well, it seems that PoE++++ is technically PoE++ type 4. But Ubiquiti has strayed a bit from the standard nomenclature, and they made up their own branding to differentiate between 802.3bt type 3 and 802.3bt type 4. Now, I say they made up their own branding. I don't know if Ubiquiti made it up. Maybe some other vendor did, and they're just also using it. But the problem in my mind is that it doesn't really scale, right? We can't just keep adding pluses to the end of PoE. And I'm not even sure if it's even possible to push beyond the 90 watts per device that 802.3bt type 4 provides. But if that does happen at some point in the future, what if the next generation of PoE becomes generally accepted as PoE++++ instead of 802.3bt type 4? I mean, it may have been better if they just played it safe and used PoE++ type 3 and type 4. And I'm genuinely curious about how many like internal meetings they had about that. So when powered up with PoE++++, or what's known as 802.3bt type 4, our little Switch Flex 2.5G PoE delivers up to 57 watts to connected devices. But which switches can actually deliver that much power to the Flex 2.5 PoE? I certainly don't have one. And as of the recording of this video, it's actually only possible with the Enterprise Campus 24 PoE and the Enterprise Campus 48 PoE. Neither of those are available yet. They are marked as coming soon on the webpage, but these are massively powerful switches with 25 gig SFP28 uplinks and plenty of 10 gig and 2.5 gig connectivity. And yes, they can push PoE++ to connected devices. Until those powerful switches come out, however, we have PoE++ or 802.3bt type 3, or you can choose to not power it with PoE directly and instead purchase a separate PoE++ injector, which is $29. But that only gives you 1 gigabit, so then you'd be bottlenecking the bandwidth of this switch. Your final option would be to purchase the $79 210 watt AC adapter. So ultimately, we get into this situation where we have to keep spending money to knock through these bottlenecks. I mean, it kind of reminds me of dealing with like a gaming PC, right? You buy a brand new game, but it doesn't run really well on your PC, so you spend a bunch of money to upgrade your video card, only to find out that your old monitors don't have DisplayPort, so now you need new monitors, right? It starts to get expensive really quick. Now, in my own network, I'd like to use this switch to replace the Lite 8 PoE switch that I have here on my test bench. But I don't have any other switches that can do 10 gig plus PoE++. I've got the Enterprise XG, which has 24 10 gig non-PoE RJ45 ports, or I have the ProMax 16 PoE, which does have PoE++, but only on its 2.5 gig ports. So that's what I'm gonna do here. I'm gonna string a cable from the ProMax 16 PoE into the Flex 2.5G PoE's 10 gig RJ45 port. I'll have that PoE++ power, but it's gonna be bottlenecked at 2.5 gigabit as far as bandwidth. But then if I ever do upgrade to a 10 gig switch that has PoE++ or PoE++ output, then I can always just upgrade at that time. Now, I've also been wanting a separate network switch on the other side of my workbench here, right? I've got one back here, but I'd love to have one like just off the side right here. So I'm also gonna install this Switch Flex Mini 2.5G. Now this is a $49 switch with 5 2.5 gigabit ports that can be powered up with 802.3 AFPoE. So when all is said and done, I'm gonna have full 2.5 gig connectivity across this entire workbench, completely powered with PoE. All right, let's get started. Okay, so here's my existing switch. This is the Lite 8 PoE. It's powered up by AC, actually. I've got an AC adapter plugged in the back here. And here is the new one. This is the Flex 2.5G PoE. As you can see, it is a little bit bigger, not too much bigger, about the same height, but definitely longer. And so the first thing I need to do is string an Ethernet cable over from my ProMax 16, and I'm gonna plug it into this PoE in port right here. So let's go take a look at that now. Here is my main network rack. We can see that Enterprise XG down there, and then right above it, we have the USW ProMax 16 with Ether lighting. That has these 2.5 gig PoE++ ports, so let's go ahead and run a cable out of one of these. The first thing I did was string an Ethernet cable from my ProMax 16 switch over to the Flex 2.5G 8 PoE. I adopted it in UniFi and it negotiated at full 2.5 gig. I then set up the Flex 2.5G 5 port switch on the other side of my desk and I plugged that into the Flex 2.5G 8 PoE as well. I adopted the 5 port Flex switch and then I opened up the port manager. Inside the port manager, I set port 8 of the 8-port Flex 2.5G PoE switch to my internet VLAN, and I set port 7 as my IoT VLAN. All in all, installing, adopting, and configuring these two switches took about 10 minutes, and now I have full 2.5 gig connectivity to my entire workbench. So let me know down in the comments below, what do you think of the Switch Flex 2.5G 8 PoE? And I'd be particularly interested in your own use cases for this device. Okay, if you'd like to keep this party going, I've hand-selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is our full UniFi setup for the 1800s era silver mining ghost town of Cerro Gordo, California. And the bottom video is my recent comparison of Starlink versus 5G for remote internet.